This game right here is Armored Core 6, and we're going to talk about it. So this is completely unscripted, so I'm just going to ramble about the game and just see where it takes me, and hopefully you guys enjoy the ride. So I've been playing Armored Core since the days of the PlayStation 1. I played Armored Core 1, I played Armored Core 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then we had that dry spell on the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One, unfortunately. And at that point, I kind of figured From Software was done with the Armored Core series. You know, they got their Demon Souls, Dark Souls, Bloodborne. So I got pretty dang excited once I saw that trailer for Armored Core 6. Honestly, I was shocked that they even like remember that game series existed. So I was hesitant, but I was excited for a new one. And I'm so glad they came back to Armored Core 6, and I'm glad they did it justice, because this game has been a lot of fun for me. So you load up your first mission, you get your basic mech, basic loadout, you got your missiles and your little machine gun, and you start killing stuff. You start figuring out the controls, boosting around a little bit more, a little bit faster, things start speeding up, and I'm getting used to the game, and I'm loving it. This is awesome. It feels kind of like the old Armored Cores. Like from Armored Core 3 and prior Armored Core 3. It feels like the old Armored Cores from like Armored Core 4 and For Answer. And then you get to the first boss, and that first boss just decimates you. And honestly, I thought it was kind of like the Demon Souls bosses, where it's like, hey, here's the first boss, you're going to get your butt kicked, and then we're going to send you on your way. So I'm getting my butt kicked, and I was like, all right, this guy's impossible, I can't beat him. I'm just gonna let him kill me. Of course, I'm shocked because you load up and you're back in the fight again. And I'm like, oh no, I gotta actually beat this guy and get better. So that's what I did. I played and I got better. So I did that and I beat that boss. And I was kind of excited to see what other bosses, you know, this game's gonna like throw at you, right? Because I love the bosses in Elden Ring. I love the bosses in Demon Souls, Bloodborne, all that stuff. So I love the fact that they kind of combined a little bit of Demon Souls with the Armored Core speed and the mech building and all that good stuff. But once you get out of that mission, you start doing other ones, start racking up that money, start building your loadout, start changing up your mech a little bit to find a build that works for you. So I'm more of a speedy person. I love speed. I love fast weapons with just a ton of ammo. So of course I went with decently fast legs, good boost, and two dual wield Gatling guns. So that was awesome. And then I got the perk where you could swap weapons on your shoulders. So whenever my Gatling guns overheated, I switched to like two machine guns and I was just blasting away. It worked out for a while for me and I really liked that a lot. And then I started learning about shotguns and how good those are. So I switched to those for a little bit. And it just kind of shocked me how just amazing the loadouts are. And you can find your own way to play and you just don't feel limited. I stayed away from guides online. I wanted to play it my way and learn what was best for me. And I think that really brought a lot of joy to me and a lot of nostalgia like I did when I was a kid. Like I didn't look up guides back in the day. I just played it how I wanted to and it would just work out. So I did that for this and I'm glad I did. I would highly recommend anyone that is playing through the game now or wants to play through the game when it's cheap, try not to ruin yourself with guides or trying to optimize it the way everyone else says. Like, play it your way. Like, make this game yours and enjoy it. And the fact, too, that you can customize the color, the look of your mech, there's quite a variety to that. You can pick whatever colors you want. There's no paywall that's saying, hey, you want this certain color of red? Well, then pay me $5 and you can get that certain color of red. Which is also leads me to the fact that there's no microtransactions. When I load up this game after a hard day of work and I just want to play, it's fantastic. I just log in and I play my game. I don't log in to get harassed by microtransactions asking me to spend $20 and that's it. It's just straight up relaxing and it's awesome. And this is what makes me so happy with From Software games lately is that they feel like full games. Like you pay your money and you're getting everything. You're not feeling like you're getting stiff to pay, you know, $40 down the line. If you were to ask me about Armored Core 6 and if it's worth the price now, I'd say yes. It's worth the price now. It's worth the price later. Whatever price you're willing to pay for this game, reasonable price, I feel like you're going to get your money's worth out of it. I feel like it's a completed game. There's tons of customization. There's none of this microtransaction harassing you bullcrap. It's just awesome. It's just a fun game. If you've played any old ones, you're going to get that nostalgia feel out of it. The store line's awesome. Missions are great. It's just, it's Armored Core. And it is a blast to play. If you're looking for your next MechWarrior game, this probably isn't it. But if you love fast-paced mech arcade combat, I mean, this is it. You're just going to have a lot of fun playing it. Yeah, that's it. Thanks for listening to me ramble about Armored Core 6. Stay safe, stay retro. I hope you find the games you're looking for, and we'll see you in the next video. Later.